हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू ग्लोबल ऑनलाइन यूनिवर्सिटी। आई एम बाहुबली देसाई। इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस सम इम्पॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चंस ऑन हायर एजुकेशन सिस्टम। फ्रेंड्स, फॉर मोर वीडियोस यू कैन विजिट आवर वेबसाइट। द लिंक फॉर वेबसाइट विल बी गिवन इन द डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स। फ्रेंड्स, एज यू ऑल नो, वी हैव ऑलरेडी स्टार्टेड प्रोवाइडिंग मॉक टेस्ट सीरीजेस फॉर इंग्लिश वर्जन, and also we are providing mock test series for Kannada in Kannada language also. And friends, we have already provided 12 mock test series for UGC NET and 4 mock test series for KSET examination. In upcoming days we are going to provide remaining mock test series. If you haven't enrolled yet, still you can enroll for our mock test series, and I hope all these mock test series will boost your preparation. Okay, let us go to the questions. Here the question is, the name of the plan to increase enrollment in higher education institution is option A, Rashtriya Uchchatara Shiksha Abhiyan RUSA, option B, Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan, option C, both A and B, option D, none of the above. Friends, please think and answer it. Here the correct answer for this question is option A, RUSA, Rashtriya Uchchatara Shiksha Abhiyan. It is right answer. Let us see some more information related to RUSA. Friends, RUSA stands for Rashtriya Uchchatara Shiksha Abhiyan. Please remember this. This abbreviation may be asked in the upcoming examination. It is the scheme for development of higher education in India, and it is initiated in the year of 2013 by MHRD, by Ministry of Human Resource Development, Government of India. Okay, RUSA stands for Rashtriya Uchchatara Shiksha Abhiyan. It is a holistic scheme of development. It is for the development of higher education in India, and it is initiated in the year of 2013 by the MHRD, and it is launched by Manmohan Singh in the period of Manmohan Singh when he was Prime Minister. This RUSA has been launched. It is under MHRD. Please remember all these points related to RUSA. And our next question is, which of the following is known as Calcutta University Commission? Option A, Sadler Commission, option B, Kothari Commission, option C, Hunter Commission, option D, Wood Dispatch. Friends, the right answer for this question is option A, Sadler Commission. He is known as the Calcutta University Commission. And friends, Sadler Commission or Calcutta University Commission, it is appointed by the Government of India in 1917. And Dr. Michael Sadler was the chairman of Sadler Commission. And Michael Sadler was the chairman of Sadler Commission. And the commission recommended the 10 plus 2 plus 3 pattern of education. And also Purdah schools established for Muslim girls by the Sadler Commission only. And intermediate classes were separated from the universities by Sadler Commission only. Please remember all these points. Sadler Commission, it is known as the Calcutta University Commission, appointed by the Government of India in 1917. Dr. Michael Sadler was the chairman of Sadler Commission, and 10 plus 2 plus 3 pattern of education is introduced by the Sadler Commission only, and Purdah schools were established for Muslim girls, and intermediate classes were separated from the universities. And also friends, this Sadler University Commission also included two Indian members. Please remember, and those two Indian members are Sir Ashutosh Mukherjee and Ziauddin Ahmad. These are the two Indian members in Sadler Commission. Let us see the next question. API stands for option A, academic parameter indicator, option B, academic performance indicator, option C, academic paid installment, option D, none of the above. Friends, the right answer for API is option B, academic performance indicator is the correct answer. And friends, API is the common abbreviation of academic performance indicators, the measure that gives away the growth of a student, teacher or an institution. Please remember this line. And this was introduced by UGC in 2010. Generally, the institutions resort to reviewing the API scores of the teaching professionals in determining whether to promote them or not to a higher position of responsibility. API stands for Academic Performance Indicators, the measure that gives away the growth of a student, teacher or an institution. This was introduced by the UGC 2010. Okay, let us see the next questions. Which of the following organizations set up the National Assessment and Accreditation Council, NAC? Okay, which of the following organization set up NAAC, NAC, a National Assessment and Accreditation Council? Option A, AICTE, option B, UGC, option C, MHRD, option D, none of the above. Friends, the right answer is the NAC is set up by UGC. UGC stands for, as you all know, University Grant Commission. Friends, the NAC, National Assessment and Accreditation Council, it is an organization that will assess and accredits higher education institutions in India. And remember friends, NAC is an autonomous body. This question may be asked in the upcoming examination. So remember, NAC is an autonomous body and it is funded by the UGC. And where is the headquarter of NAC? It is located in Bengaluru. And S.C. Sharma is the executive of NAC. And NAC founded in the year of 1994 by UGC. I hope you all will remember these points. The next question is, first open university in India was option A, Andhra Pradesh Open University, option B, Indira Gandhi National Open University, option C, Delhi University, option D, none of the above. Friends, the right answer for this question is option A, Andhra Pradesh Open University. It is the first open university in India. And friends, it is this Andhra Pradesh Open University is known as the Dr. B.R. Ambedkar Open University. It is located in Hyderabad in Andhra Pradesh. And the first open university, Andhra Pradesh Open University, was set up on 26th August 1982. Please remember the year. It was set up in the year of 1982. Okay, it is known as the first open university of India. Let us see the next question. Friends, the question is, the foundation training of IAS officers is conducted where? Option A, LBS National Academy of Public Administration, Mussoorie. Option B, MG Institute of Public Administration, Chandigarh. Option C, UPSC, New Delhi. Option D, all state capitals. Friends, where IAS officers training will be conducted? It is at LBS National Academy of Public Administration, Mussoorie. Please remember friends, we'll see some more information related to LBS. Okay friends, LBS stands for Lal Bahadur Shastri National Academy of Administration. It is a research and training institute. Please remember, Lal Bahadur Shastri National Academy of Administration is a research and training institute on public policy and public administration in India, and it is operated by Indian Union Government. And LSBNAA, Lal Bahadur Shastri National Academy, of administration located at Mussoorie in Uttarakhand. Okay, and director of the LBSNA is Sanjeev Chopra, and it is founded in the year of 1959, and LBSNA is affiliated to Government of India. Friends, you have to remember all these points because a question may come from here. Our next question is, which of the following was the first private institution? Friends, first private institution to be granted the status of deemed university in 1976. Option A, Manipal Academy of Higher Education. Option B, Symbiosis Institute, Pune. Option C, Thapar University, Patiala. Option D, Amity University, Noida. Friends, the correct answer is Manipal Academy of Higher Education. We can also call it as MAHE. MAHE stands for, please remember this, Manipal Academy of Higher Education. Friends, here you can see the photo of Manipal Academy of Higher Education, and it is formerly known as the Manipal University. And remember friends, it is a private institute deemed to be university, located in the university town of Manipal, Udupi, Karnataka, India. Okay, it is located in Manipal and it is a private research institute deemed to be university. And also friends, remember Manipal Academy of Higher Education, MAHE, has branch campuses in Dubai and in Mangaluru. Please remember. The next question is, which of the following has the most profound impact on our constitution? Option A, Government of India Act 1935. Option B, Constitution of USA. Option C, Constitution of UK. Option D, Constitution of Ireland. Friends, here the right answer is option A, Government of India Act 1935. Friends, the Government of India Act 1935 was an act of Parliament of United Kingdom. Please remember this, the Government of India Act 1935, it is an act of Parliament of the UK. Then it originally received royal assent in August 1935. And remember one more thing, until 1999, it was the longest act of Parliament ever enacted. Until 1999, this act was the longest act. Okay, the Great London Authority Act 1999 surpassed its length. Please remember these 2 points. Until 1999, Government Act of India 1935 was longest act of Parliament, but the Greater London Authority Act 1999 surpassed its length. Okay, and the Government Act of India 1935 originally published in the year of 1935, and it is commencement date is 1st April 1937. I hope you will remember all these points. Let us move to the next question. Fundamental duties were incorporated in the Indian Constitution by the option A, 32nd Amendment, option B, 42nd Amendment, option C, 44th Amendment, option D, 76th Amendment. Friends, the right answer is option B, 42nd Amendment. And friends, remember the fundamental duties of citizens were added to the constitution by 42nd Amendment in the year of 1976. Please remember, and upon the who has recommended it? The recommendation of Swaran Singh Committee. Please remember, fundamental duties were added to constitution by 42nd Amendment in the year of 1976, and by the recommendation of Swaran Singh Committee. Let us see the next question. Which of the following is not a fundamental right? I hope you can easily answer this question. Option A, right to equality. Yeah, it is a fundamental right. Right against exploitation. It is also fundamental right. Right to freedom of speech and expression. It is also fundamental right. Right of pre-compulsory education for all children up to the age of 14. It is not a fundamental right. So option D is the right answer. And friends, please remember all these six fundamental rights. One is right to equality. Second one is right to freedom. Third one is right against exploitation. Fourth one is cultural and educational rights. Fifth one is right to freedom of religion. Sixth one is right to constitutional remedies. These are the six fundamental rights of in India. Okay, and initially there were seven fundamental rights, but right to property was removed. Okay, let us see the next question. How do directive principles of state policy differ from fundamental rights? Option A, the former are meant for union territories, whereas the latter are for states. Option B, the former are not enforceable, whereas the latter are enforceable. Option C, the former are not a part of the constitution, whereas the latter are the part of constitution. Option D, none of the above. Friends, the right answer is option B, directive principles are not enforceable, whereas the fundamental rights are enforceable. Please remember. Okay friends, here some more information is there. Fundamental rights are justifiable. Please remember, fundamental rights are justifiable and also enforceable. But directive principles are non-justifiable and cannot override fundamental rights. Next, fundamental rights provide political rights, whereas social and economic rights are provided by the directive principles. Okay, fundamental rights will provide political rights and directive principles will provide social and economic rights. Next, fundamental rights are mentioned in the article from 12 to 35. Please remember, fundamental rights are mentioned in the article from 12 to 35. And directive principles are mentioned from article 36 to 51. A question may come from here, so you have to remember these articles. So let us see the next question. Bills are normally introduced in the parliament. Option A, during question hour. Option B, during 0 hour. Option C, soon after lunch break. Option D, shortly before the house adjourns for the day. Friends, the right answer is option B, during 0 hour. Bills are normally introduced in the parliament during 0 hour. So B is the correct answer. Friends, the next question is, in a parliamentary form of government, the real powers of the state are vested in the option A, Council of Ministers, option B, President, option C, Government, option D, Parliament. Friends, the right answer is option A, Council of Ministers. In parliamentary form of government, the real powers of the state are vested in the Council of Ministers. Friends, in a parliamentary form of government, real powers of the state are vested in the Prime Minister and his Council of Ministers. Please remember, this is because the Prime Minister is the chief spokesperson of the executive as well as the leader of Lok Sabha. Please remember all these points. Let us see the next question. Money can be spent out of the consolidated fund of India with the approval of. Okay. To spend amount from the consolidated fund, whose approval is needed? Option A, President. Option B, Parliament. Option C, कंट्रोलर एंड ऑडिटर जनरल, ऑप्शन डी फाइनेंस मिनिस्टर। फ्रेंड्स पार्लियामेंट अप्रूवल इज नीडेड, सो ऑप्शन बी इज द करेक्ट आंसर। नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज हू हैज द अथॉरिटी टू डिसाइड वेदर अ बिल इज मनी बिल और नॉट। ऑप्शन ए प्राइम मिनिस्टर, ऑप्शन बी लोकसभा स्पीकर, ऑप्शन सी प्रेसिडेंट, ऑप्शन डी चीफ जस्टिस ऑफ इंडिया। फ्रेंड्स द राइट आंसर इज द लोकसभा स्पीकर हैज द अथॉरिटी टू डिसाइड वेदर अ पर्टिकुलर बिल इज मनी बिल और नॉट। ओके, अ बिल विच स्पीकर सर्टिफाइज टू बी अ मनी बिल इज अ मनी बिल एंड द डिसीजन ऑफ द स्पीकर कैन नॉट बी क्वेश्चन। प्लीज रिमेंबर द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज व्हेन द लोकसभा इज डिसॉल्व्ड द स्पीकर कंटिन्यूज इन ऑफिस टिल ए न्यू। ऑप्शन ए प्रेसिडेंट प्रिसाइडिंग ऑफिसर इज अपॉइंटेड, ऑप्शन बी स्पीकर इज इलेक्टेड व्हेन द न्यू हाउस मीट्स, ऑप्शन सी लोकसभा इज फॉर्म्ड, ऑप्शन डी डेप्यूटी स्पीकर इज अपॉइंटेड। फ्रेंड्स द राइट आंसर इज ऑप्शन बी स्पीकर इज इलेक्टेड व्हेन द न्यू हाउस मीट्स। व्हेन द लोकसभा विल बी डिसॉल्व्ड द स्पीकर हैज टू कंटिन्यू इन ऑफिस टिल अ न्यू स्पीकर इज इलेक्टेड व्हेन द न्यू हाउस मीट्स। Here it is according to Article 94. Please remember this also. According to Article 94 of Indian Constitution, whenever the House of the People is dissolved, the Speaker shall not vacate his office immediately before the first meeting of the House. The Speaker continues in office till a new Speaker is elected. Remember all these points, friends. Now the next question is, members of Rajya Sabha are elected according to option A cumulative vote system, option B single non-transferable vote system, single transferable vote system, option D none of the above. Friends, member of Rajya Sabha are elected according to single transferable vote system. Please remember the next question is the governor of a state He is appointed by the option A chief minister, option B chief justice, option C president, option D prime minister. Friends, the right answer is option C president. The governor of a state he is appointed by the president. The governor of a state shall be appointed by the president by warrant under his hand and seal according to article 155. Please remember friends, it comes under article 155. And a person to be eligible for appointment as governor should be citizen of India and has completed the age of 35 according to article 157. Remember all these things. Our next question is which article of the constitution directs the government to organize village panchayats? Article 32, Article 40, Article 48, Article 51. Friends, the right answer is Article 40. Okay, friends, according to the Constitution of India, Article 40, organization of village panchayats, the state shall take steps to organize village panchayats and endow them with such powers and authority as may be necessary to enable them to function as unit of self-government. Okay, establish of village panchayats is related to article 40. Friends, thank you very much. Thank you for watching this video. If you want more questions, please visit our website and enroll for our mock test series. We have started our mock test series for UGC NET and also for KSET examination.